In this lecture, we will cover continuous integration. Here, the learning objective is to understand the use and purpose of continuous integration. This is marked as K2. Now let's see the activities of continuous integration. These are the 6 activities of continuous integration. Static code analysis. Compile. Unit test. Deploy. Integration test. And report. Where we perform static code analysis on the developed code. And once testing is done, we provide the report. Then we compile and link the code and generate the executable files. Once the code is completed, we perform unit testing on it and report the test result. And once unit testing is done, we move to the deployment phase, where we install the build into the test environment. Build is nothing but compiled code. Once the deployment is done, we can perform integration testing on it and generate the report. At the end, we are posting the status of all the activities to a publicly visible location or email status to the team. Now, this picture shows the complete workflow of a continuous integration process. Once the source code is developed and available, we do version controlling of it. That means we provide a unique ID to it so that it is easily identifiable. Then we start the build process, where we complete the compiling and linking process and executable files are generated. Then we perform the static code analysis on it. And once that is done, we perform unit testing on the code by running automated test scripts. After that, we analyze the generated report to see code coverage. Once all the things are fine, we store the result and it's called artifacts. Once the unit testing is done, we move to the functional testing of the code. For that, first we have to set up the test environment by changing it to test new features. Once the test environment is ready, we can run functional testing automated scripts. Then we can publish the over result or email to the development team. This process continues until all the features are implemented. That is why it is called a continuous integration process. But you just have to remember that continuous integration has 6 activities. Static code analysis, compile, unit test, deploy, integration test, and report. One of the important aspects of continuous integration is that we have to regularly run automated tests. An automated build and test process takes place on a daily basis and detects integration errors early and quickly. Continuous integration allows agile testers to run automated tests regularly, in some cases as part of the continuous integration process itself, and send quick feedback to the team on the quality of the code. These test results are visible to all team members, especially when automated reports are integrated into the process. Another of the important aspects of continuous integration is regression testing. Automated regression testing can be continuous throughout the iteration. Good automated regression tests cover as much functionality as possible, including user stories delivered in the previous iterations. Good coverage in the automated regression tests helps support building and testing large integrated systems. When the regression testing is automated, the agile testers are freed to concentrate their manual testing on new features, implemented changes, and confirmation testing of defect fixes. Continuous integration also helps in continuous quality control. Let's see how. In addition to automated tests, organizations use continuous integration, typically use build tools to implement continuous quality control. In addition to running unit and integration tests, such tools can run additional static and dynamic tests, measure and profile performance, extract and format documentation from the source code, and facilitate manual quality assurance processes. This continuous application of quality control aims to improve the quality of the product as well as reduce the time taken to deliver it by replacing the traditional practice of applying quality control after completing all development. And in most of the organizations, build tools are linked to automatic deployment tools. Let's see why. Build tools can be linked to automatic deployment tools, which can fetch the appropriate build from the continuous integration or build server and deploy it into one or more development, test, staging, or even production environments. This reduces the errors and delays associated with relying on specialized staff or programmers to install releases in these environments. Continuous integration requires the use of tools, including tools for testing, tools for automating the build process, and tools for version control. In this lecture, we covered 6 activities of continuous integration: static code analysis, compile, unit test, deploy, integration test, and report. Then we saw 2 aspects of continuous integration: regularly run automated tests and regression testing. Then we saw how continuous integration helps in continuous quality control. In the next lecture, we will cover the benefit and risk of continuous integration.